What's up, y'all, man? It's your boy D2Fake. Come back with another video, man. This one's by sWooZie called Sexy Sleepover. So let's go ahead and get into it.
I got this friend. We're going to call her Laura Croft. Little backstory on Laura. We're cuddle buddies. Kissing is like one of my favorite things to do. Yeah, I'm a freak. I don't care who you tell. I'm just out here trying to provide the family content that Gotham needs.
Okay.
Platonic friendship, but the other half, we just make out a lot and we're all over each other. Funny thing about all this is her mom actually knew. Her mom acted like the cool mom from Mean Girls. Her mom really wanted us to date, but me and Laura, we good. So one day Laura texts me, yo, my birthday's this weekend, my friend Panda's in town, I'm having a party, come through. Me personally, I'm not a huge fan of house parties, like you show up and it's 15
yeah, me neither.
And three girls.
That's so usually how it is too.
After about 15 minutes. Now Laura's house is 3 hours that way. Drive over to her house, walk in, and there's 15 dudes and two girls. So then she starts introducing me to her friends. She's like, oh, this is my friend Gabe. Gabe. That name sounds familiar. This is my friend Aaron. That name sounds familiar too. This is my friend Justin. And then it hits me. These are all dudes who are her ex-cuddle buddies.
Oh, man.
She's locked in the friend zone and they're just trying to get out. The other half are her ex-cuddle buddies. The testosterone in the air was so thick, you could cut it with a Knievel. So then she introduced me to her friend Panda, and Panda is Blasian. Anybody who doesn't know what a Blasian is? It's somebody who's half black, half Asian. And she's obsessed with anime. I think most Blasians, it's in your DNA, like, you have to love anime. Panda was cute, but she definitely had a chap lip level 4 situation going on that night, so I want to just be like, yeah, this chapstick, there you go, much better. So me and Panda's talking about anime and a bunch of random stuff. I'm sitting here watching every single dude at this party try to get with Laura. Fellas, I'm gonna talk to you for a second, and you can use this in life, like this party could be an analogy for other parts of your life. Every dude at this party is being thirsty. That's DLV, demonstration of lower value. And I decide, I'm gonna go DHV, demonstration of higher value. DHV, it's your actions. You've probably heard the saying, yeah. Nice guys finish last. Girls love nice guys. It's DLV, different situation. Anyways, on with the story.
So I feel them, I feel them.
Mrs. Croft comes out of her bedroom and she's like, what kind of party is this? Nobody's drinking? Turn up, I'm the cool mom. 21, so it's Gucci. She starts pouring everybody wine or not wine, you know, it's whatever. It's not important what it is that they're pouring. There's some more backstory on Laura that I forgot to tell you guys. She's wild AF. You know, you have those friends you have to hold back, like you can't be as spontaneous or as crazy as you are because they're on the same Wi-Fi as you. Laura's not that girl. She's like, Panda, come here. She goes to her drawer, gets some tape, grabs a bottle, and tapes it to Panda's hand. You can't take this off tonight until I say so. And I actually recorded it. Live footage, no clickbait.
Yo, he's not playing. On,
every dude is still trying to get with Laura. I'm not trying to be a number in line, but I'm also being team antisocial. And I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna flip the switch and I'm gonna have a good time tonight. So I grab the Uno cards on the table. I'm like, yo, prison Uno.
Gotta play it. Gotta play it.
So me, Panda, Mrs. Croft, and a few dudes start playing California Prison Uno. Check the description if you want to know how to play. Two or three games in, I'm like, yo, let's make it interesting. Each game, the winner doesn't have to take a shot, but all the losers do.
So yeah, I like game, that. I like that.
I win, everybody takes a drink. Next game, I win, everybody drinks. I win like 5 games in a row. You know, this is not even fair anymore. So from here on out, any games that I win, I'll drink with y'all. After about an hour, I have not lost 1 game.
Dang.
All right, y'all, I've been drinking a little too much. I need to sober up so I could drive home. I don't remember exactly what Mrs. Croft said to me. All I remember is she made some slick comment out the side of her mouth. Now, some quick backstory on Mrs. Croft. Whenever she sees me, which isn't often, she likes to flirt a bit. And she's a young single mom who never leaves the house. So I know she's not getting a lot of love these days. So then I got the idea, this would be a good time to do something nice for her, but disguise it as me putting her in her place. I stand up, walk over to her, put my hands on her face, and kiss her. Yeah, I'm a freak. I don't care who I'm out here trying to provide the family-friendly content that this platform needs. And everybody's like, oh my God! And the house exploded.
Bro.
So a lot of these dudes realize they're not going to get with Laura tonight, so they slowly start trickling out one by one. And then after a while, it's just me, Laura, Mrs. Croft, Panda, and like four dudes. So one of the guys that are left are like, hey, y'all, let's go outside on the patio and smoke. I don't smoke anything, so I sway over to the couch and lay down. I'm laying down, my eyes start getting a little heavy, and all of a sudden Panda's standing over me, and she's looking at me like I'm steak. I know she saw me kiss Mrs. Croft, and she's probably sitting here like, I want a taste now. I can see the gears in her head turning like, I shouldn't do this, but I really should, but I shouldn't. Because she knows me and Laura were cuddle buddies, so you can see that going on in her head, but her face is still getting closer to the boom. Yeah, girl, give me them chaplains.
She wanted it, bro. She wanted it.
And the thoughts in my head, like, okay, let me shut this down before somebody, and then all of a sudden I hear, what the f***? Boom, Mrs. Croft caught us in the act. Panda, you know my daughter likes him. Adonde, you should be ashamed of yourself. So now I feel like crap, and then I fall asleep. And I don't even realize I fall asleep, and I wake up in a pitch black room on a bed. I actually have superpowers. And when I drink sometimes, I can't control my powers, so I start teleporting all over the place. It's very annoying. I wake up to what feels like somebody sucking on my ear. All I hear is... either A, go back to sleep, or B, not go back to sleep. Turn, and this whoever this is just starts kissing me. We're kissing, she's feeling me up, okay... this is happening. I start feeling up her face in the dark just to make sure this isn't Mrs. Croft. Okay, perfectly tweezed eyebrows. Okay, we good. I'm just going to go ahead and assume this is Laura. On my other side, all of a sudden I feel somebody else's hand. I turn. That person starts kissing me. Okay. Volume check. Big, juicy, chappy, blazing. Check. I'm going to assume that's Panda. This all escalated very, very quickly. So now I'm like, wait, no, what? Okay. Yeah, here you go, hunt. So this is going on for like 5-10 minutes. Kissing,
bro.
Hands everywhere, saliva everywhere. And I hear Panda in my ear, like, should we? We shouldn't, right? No, should we? No, should we? We shouldn't, right? I know what she's trying to put on the table.
Uh-huh.
Should we make this really easy for all of us? No, we shouldn't. Let's you know, we'll keep it here in this bubble. And B, Laura... you need to go lock that door, because if your mom comes in here, we're all dead. Some of y'all have seen the tutorial video. There are situations in life that we're just thrown into. I've learned my lesson. So Laura gets up, goes over and locks the door, comes back. We get back to it. Red light. Okay, green light.
How do you go say that?
Green light. Had I made myself a number earlier, I probably wouldn't be in this situation right now. DHV, people. That's my...
Alright, man, that was Swoozy, Sexy Sleepover, man. Like and subscribe to my channel. This man is hilarious, dude. Peace.